back to another vlog. It's been about 3 weeks since my last vlog, 3 weeks since the season finished, and we've kind of just been adjusting to having no footy commitments on, so it's been kind of good. We've been cruising around doing pretty much the same thing every day, waking up, coffee, park, home, in the pool, kids go to sleep, and then kind of just dawdling around for the rest of the day until dinner. We had the Cowboys ball last week, which was a pretty cool night, cool way to end my time at the Cowboys, but I stuffed up a... So at the Broncos, when I was there for about 10 years, we were given suits at the start of the year. Every type of fancy situation would have to wear our club suit. So, just automatically thinking that I had to wear my club suit to the end of year ball, I wore my club suit to the end of year ball and no one else was wearing it. Come on, Flay. So I had kind of an idea, but only on the way to the ball. I was driving to the ball and a few of the boys were driving past me. I was looking at them, I was like, that doesn't look like the club suit. So I got to where the ball was and I was driving around the car park waiting for one of the boys to get out of the car. I was a bit late. And one of the boys rocked up and had this little bow tie on and I had the club long tie on. So I looked at him and I was just like, what am I doing? So I ripped my tie off, threw it in the car, filthy on myself that I didn't check, went inside and just wore my shirt unbuttoned. But it was all right because there was a lot of people that had shirts with no ties and I was worried that I was gonna be the only one, but it actually turned out not too bad. So it was Jella's 4th birthday last week. My dad and his wife came up for the day, for the weekend actually. She had an awesome day. We went over to Magnetic Island on the boat. Spent most of the day at the beach and had lunch and then came home, and by the end of it she was wrecked. She loves her nanny and called her so much, so we knew that she was going to have an awesome day. But I've been planning for a little while a video to do for her. I know she's still too young to kind of appreciate it, but I thought it'd be cool for her when she grows up to watch that and yeah, just enjoy it. I got my friend Robbie to come and film us down at the beach. The tide was right out, sun was setting. It was actually a perfect afternoon and me and Jada were just running around, just having fun. I took some sparklers down there as well and yeah, it was just a nice afternoon. So I'm really happy with the way it turned out.
Dear Jayla, before you, life went around in circles. Didn't see the beauty in everyday things. Dusk meant the end to a day. Dawn meant I had to wake up. Now following your reactions to seeing things for the first time has made me realize to appreciate the beauty that surrounds us every day. Before you, sacrifice meant something so little. I had ambition, but no reason behind my motivation until you came along. Before you, birthdays were just another day. Now they are so special. This may be the last birthday that you're not at school, not a little girl. So when you do grow up and watch this, remember, you will always be Daddy's little girl no matter how old you get. Happy birthday, my beautiful darling. Daddy will always love you.
You know, the reason I make these videos and the reason that I started vlogging, and you know, for one, I love being creative and I get a joy out of making something and then watching it back and just enjoying it and sharing it. But another reason is, if something does ever happen to me, my kids will grow up having these videos there that they can always watch back. And no matter how old they get, they will always know the character I was, because you know, I try to be myself as much as I can in front of the camera, so that's part of the reason why I do that, because I want my kids, if something bad does happen, touch wood, they'll always know what type of person I was. So this weekend was a massive weekend. I actually shot my first two gigs on the weekend. My first gig was a gym video at PLC. The owner actually emailed me a while back asking for some content and I was keen as to work with him, but I just didn't want to commit to something that I didn't know I could deliver on. Just because I'm not too sure where I'll be over the next month or two, and not too sure whether I'll be in Townsville or where I'll be, to be honest. Just quickly on that, I'm not too sure where I'm going yet, so for anyone asking, I don't know. Do you know? But yeah, when I emailed back, I said I couldn't commit to all of the content that you guys want, so I gave them my friend Robbie's contact and told them to contact him, and I told them if Robbie does some work in the future, I'm happy to come down and help out just for the experience. So that was my first gig. Robbie's going to edit it all and send it off to them and hopefully build a relationship with PLC.
You're welcome, Robbie. Yeah.
But my biggest gig so far was definitely have to be the second gig I've done, which was a wedding. Let me tell you the story around it. Matty Bowen, who's a goat of the NRL, goat of rugby league, freak. I think I played against them a couple of times. I played against them when I was at the Broncos and we played Wigan in the World Cup Challenge. So that was who was getting married, but because they only planned it in the space of, I think, about 3 weeks, they hadn't planned for a videographer. So they asked me on Friday night and their wedding was on the Sunday. So yeah, I was pretty nervous because it was Matty Bowen for a start, but it was going to be my first wedding, so I wanted to do a good job for Matty and Rudy as well. You know, such a special time, such a special part of people's life, and I didn't really want to stuff that up. But I think I've done a good job. Obviously, I'm only going to keep getting better the more I do them. Pretty keen to get into them. I was pretty nervous at the start. Went to the Ville and shot all the prep stuff of them getting ready. And then after that, I was into it pretty much. I was walking around just confident as. I actually had Vicky Miller doing photography and she helped me out a lot. She was just telling everyone, you be here, do this, do that, do this. And I was just floating around with my camera, just kind of right next to her, taking shots, coming away, taking some more shots, and then she'd move them around and I'd come back in. So it was actually pretty easy having her there. Go check her stuff out, she's actually really good. But yeah, I smashed the edit over a couple of days. I got home late after the wedding, probably about 11:30. But Monday night, I stayed up pretty much all night till about 2 a.m. And then I woke up on Tuesday morning and didn't like the music at all. If you make videos, I think you'd understand, but I just, yeah. You kind of know when it's right and it's not right, and all the copyright stuff these days makes it so hard to choose good music. But I finished it in the end. Here's a little snippet.
Are you ready to love me? I'm ready to love you. I'm down on my knees, babe. It's all or nothing, yeah. If you're only for me, yeah, then I'm only for you, baby. Tell me if you're ready to love me. I'm ready to love you. I'm ready, yeah, I'm ready to love you. I'm ready, yeah, I'm ready to love you. She's the one.
So yeah, that was the wedding. It actually came out pretty nice. It was one of my goals of 2019 to film a wedding at the end of the year. I hadn't had any locked in, so it was kind of good that this one popped up and I was able to do it. So congratulations, Matt and Rudy, on your beautiful wedding. I wish you nothing but the best in the future. And thank you so much for allowing me to shoot my first wedding at your guys' beautiful wedding. But yeah, it's been a big last week. That'll be us over the next probably month or so, trying to figure out where we're going to be, pack this house up, fit a little holiday in there. Yeah, that's the vlog. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to follow me on Instagram at jordan.kahu, and as always, kick it like this. I wanna